people who shave or wax private parts for a living. What are your horror stories? STDs, unknown smells, unknown discharge, and a guy who blew his load everywhere while I was waxing his balls. Beauty industry is not glamorous at all. Not my story, but our teacher in beauty school. She was waxing someone on her period. Not uncommon. Just wear a tampon. And she didn't realize that the wax had stuck to her tampon string. When she went to pull the strip, the tampon flew out and was obviously an embarrassing mess. Now we're taught to put an applicator over the string or push it out of the way while laying the strip. Laser tech for 4 years. Lady started her period on the table mid-session. Luckily the area was completely covered for sanitization and I was almost done zapping her. Finished up and sent her on her way. She was mortified. I felt bad for her. Not her fault. Aunt Flo is a nasty cruel bee sometimes. LOL. She gave me a generous tip though. That was nice. LOL. The one time in my life I went to an STD clinic place to get tested, this friggin' happened to me. Bled on the doctor's hand pretty profusely. She was a doll about it at least. My buddy's sister got a job doing that. She said she had to watch a video that graphically showed what happened if you fricked up waxing a scrotum. Long story short, you can get your nutsack ripped wide open. Nope, 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 I'm out. Ex and I were in the BDSM community. My ex had found a really good waxer. Friend of a friend asked about the waxing job on display at an event, so the name was given out. The waxer stopped waxing men because the friend of a friend moaned and panted during the waxing and then had an orgasm on her table. That'd stop me too. My mom was an aesthetician and she told me of a horror story she had. A woman came in for a Brazilian waxing, a regular of my mom's. My mom said that she must have been dehydrated that day, which can make the skin easier to tear, because when she pulled the strip away, she ripped her lady bits. Blood everywhere. My mom described it as looked like a bowling ball down there. The woman was totally chill and made a joke saying something along the lines of, "I guess I won't be having sex for a while." It took a while to heal, but she eventually did go back to my mom as a regular again, and made sure she was hydrated. I had no idea that could happen. Sounds painful AF. Not a beautician, but briefly dated one for a bit. She had a guy come in and get his balls and butthole waxed, claiming it was for a hot date that he had that night. She said that he was kind of weird and a little creepy, but she brushed it off. Her and I get dinner after work and her phone is blowing up. The guy had tracked her down on Facebook and went through and liked every single picture that she had posted in the last 5 years. Dude was immediately banned from every coming back. I talked to a beautician friend about this once, so I'll just get the big one out of the way. People who don't wipe properly and lie about it like they did. My wife was an aesthetician for many years and did full Brazilian waxes. She would routinely tell people that male clients always show up freshly showered and seem to constantly worry that they're not clean enough, as if the person who rips hairs out of your grundle is judging your personal hygiene. The worst, she said, is the women that would show up where you could smell that they'd recently had sex. Either the smell of latex condoms or, in some instances, bodily fluids that are not her own leaking out as they lay there on the table chatting about their day. OMG. I can't imagine walking to the mailbox with CM trickling out, let alone showing up for anything as intimate as a waxing. What the heck? Not an aesthetician or anything like that, but I did once queef during a session and I was mortified. The poor girl didn't even bat an eye and said it was okay, but I was counting down the minutes to be done and go hide in my room for the rest of the day. The client was just talking to the aesthetician and you got in the way. So this isn't my story, but my colleague's. We are both dermatology PAs. She went to a large cosmetic conference and attended a waxing seminar by a well-known aesthetician. She was doing a Brazilian wax on a young man live on stage. When she pulled off the strip of wax, his scrotum tore, and one of his testicles fell out. It was still connected to his body. The aesthetician was a total pro and explained that this is a rare, but potential wax complication in guys. So the audience got to see firsthand how to manage this particularly horrific complication. The guy was apparently as cool as a cucumber. You would have to be get a Brazilian with a live audience. He was apparently completely fine after getting put back together by medical personnel. If somebody ripped my bollock open with wax, I think I'd have something to say about it. Oof. When I worked at a spa, I would be the model for new hires to practice Brazilian waxing. One lady decided to become an esthetician late in life. Even with glasses, she did not have the best eyesight. She eventually swung one of the attachments for facials over me, essentially just a giant magnifying glass so she could try to tweeze anything she missed. That woman also lifted skin and left bruises. Another woman practicing could not get the wax off. The room was too hot, so the wax wasn't working right. I was spread eagle holding a fan at my lady bits. Baby powder flying everywhere. A lot of my co-workers came in to see what was going on. About 8 people got to see my downstairs mix up that day. They did eventually get the wax off. I know a lot of aestheticians and most have stories about being farted on. They usually don't even bat an eye at toilet paper that got left behind. One friend calls it clitty litter. While in aesthetic school during Brazilian training, I was a model for 2 girls. One of the girls spreads my butt cheeks apart to the point my skin was hurting to evaluate the situation, and she commented on how nice my butthole was. We'll say it was extremely awkward and interesting sitting there on all 4s while they wax me, lol. Just for reference, typically when waxing you start from the back coming forward, or at least that's how we were taught. A bit late to the party, and this isn't my story, but an old co-worker's. She had a woman come for assorted spa and aesthetic services. When they got to the Brazilian, my poor co-worker learned this woman was wearing a diaper, all sorted and on the table, ready to begin. And the woman shoots on the table. There was no Brazilian for her that day or any day since. It was a rough day at work for men. I'm going to pretend it's not a weird fetish thing and the poor woman has no control of her bowels and bladder. I wasn't the practitioner, but my BF and I were practice models thanks to my high pain tolerance, and he was the only male willing to do it. They did sugaring practice. I had a girl get her hand sugar wax glued to my arm for 20 minutes. Another get her hand stuck literally to my BF butt cheeks. And a third girl got her glob of wax stuck to her own face dart, all in the span of one session. I felt so bad for them. The trainer had to go get the dissolve spray stuff to unstick everyone. Also, one girl apparently accidentally got a tampon stuck to the wax and pulled earlier that week. My best friend is a waxer. During her initial training, they asked if anyone wanted to try waxing a male. She figured, why not? Give it her best and learn the technique. Apparently you have to apply a bit of pressure to the testicles when waxing the male bits. So she applies pressure to her client's testicles, adds the wax, and as she waxes him, he ejaculates all over himself. She was absolutely shocked because he didn't say anything about it, and he was completely she played it cool, left the room, let him clean himself up and leave. When her supervisor came by to see how everything went, she explained the situation and the supervisor was mortified. She said, "You should have told us immediately. That's not supposed to happen. She's been a waxer for the last 5 years and only waxes females." I have an esthetician friend, and she told me that some people will come in straight from the gym, no shower or anything. Even with masks, she said it doesn't hide the smell. Not private parts, but in cosmetology school we were broke into groups at one point to learn how to wax. There was this one girl who, don't want to get into it, because of chosen personal difficulties no one wanted to partner with. I felt bad, so I let her wax my arm. She didn't take it seriously, only did half my lower arm overlapped areas which can cause burning and severe irritation. Kept laughing like it was hilarious. Didn't take the lesson seriously. She got kicked out of class and reprimanded for the harm she could have caused. I was fine for the most part, but I was super red and rashy from all of the overlapping. The worst part was I couldn't shave to match because of how raw my skin was, so I ended up finishing the wax myself. Chosen personal difficulties, this is a gem. I do not wax, but I work at a waxing salon. Worst thing I've ever heard was that a woman had gotten her lips stuck together cause the waxer got wax on them and it took days to come off. Personally, one time a waxer stopped and looked right at my coochie and squinted before parting my lips with her fingers. Didn't tell me anything either, like, girl, what did you see? Maybe she saw a tiny little man waving at her from yeah nevers. Worked at a spa for 10 years. Esties complained about women who had TP and dingleberries stuck to them. Women who would come in after working all day and didn't shower before their Brazilian wax. Others had STDs and would still spread their legs with no shame. Once had a waxer who accidentally stuck her fingers inside a woman while waxing. So that was fun dealing with that. She was fired. I just got a vasectomy on Friday. The nurse shaving me before the procedure was probably the most terrifying 30 seconds of my life. I felt like I survived a trial from a Saw movie. Haha, my dad also told that the most frightening thing about the whole procedure was the shaving. I really don't have any horror stories, but I will say this, after keeping my nether regions waxed for well over a decade, once I do forego maintenance, it resembles a cat with a severe case of mange, which is now my new permanent look. Oh wow, I have so many. I am a full body waxer and I probably do 15-25 Brazilians a day. The amount of women who come in with poop in their butts is astounding. Like it's a regular topic of convo between me and my co-workers. I used to have a male Brazilian client who would always tell me I was hot during his wax and then ask me to leave the room when I was finished so he could get dressed, in private, after I already saw the whole kit and caboodle. And then there would always be a mountain of tissues in the garbage. Not discreet, bro. So what happens if a man pops a boner during the wax? Or does that not happen while you're pouring hot wax on people? I've told this story before on Reddit. But I had a female friend who used to work in a waxing salon. When I asked her why she quit, she gave a small shudder and talked about an obese sweaty woman who came in for a bikini wax. When I was on my knees and 2 inches away from a vagina that hadn't been washed in about a week, I knew this wasn't what I wanted to do in my life. See, this makes no sense. I get Brazilians, but I pride myself on my hygiene and cleanliness. I can't understand how you would care enough about how your area looks, but not care enough to keep it clean. I just can't wrap my mind around it. Bromhidrosis, hyperhidrosis, and she kept hyperventilating. I wanted to stop the service but she was a model for my aesthetician training. Should've gotten one of the cosmetology students, instead. A coworker was doing this nice lady's bikini, when the time comes to do around the butthole. The lady grins and says you'll get a little surprise, so co-worker, of course, wants to know what she means. Client tries to get cute by going oh, you'll see. How her co-worker stands her ground, so the client finally says that she was back from a trip where she. Oh god damn it. I'm leaving my phone in the garbage. Goodbye. My wax girl told me one of her first waxes was a woman who'd given birth 2 weeks prior. I can't go into details. I won't do that to you. Friend of mine was doing beauty therapy at college, and was coming up to the end, about to become fully qualified. One thing the college did was essentially operate a beauty therapy place in much the same way as dental students practicing dentistry under the supervision of trained dentists. Customers would come for certain treatments and would essentially fill in a long survey and rate all sorts of different things, and that would essentially inform your grade. So, a woman comes in for a full frontal wax, nothing terribly exotic about that, nice and easy. She follows instructions, get on the table, etc. Friend prepares the wax, strip papers, applies the wax, gets her first strip, smooths it on, and, THWAP. The wax strip, now loose, flies out of her hand and slap, sticks on the wall across the room, pubes sticking out like so many spiders' legs. Even worse though, what else is there? Her tampon dangling from the bottom. Both of them are absolutely paralyzed with shock, until my friend gathered her wits and left the room so the customer could sort herself out, inwardly cursing at what now appears to be a guaranteed fail. She came back in, finished off the wax session in what I can imagine was horrifying awkwardness, and saw the customer off. Upon cleaning up, came out, was about to explain herself to her teacher, picked up the forms filled in by the customer, 10/10 across the board, magical. You know what, after reading some of the more horrific stories before yours, this was actually a really nice story, loved it. I'm not sure I want to know the answer to this question. It's similar to how we got the Swamps of Dagobah post from last decade. That was the first thing I thought of when I saw the butt pimple post. In the waxing parlor, they gave me some wet wipes to clean myself, before they come in the room and start. I wanted to be extra clean, so I used up the two pieces of wet wipes and wanted more. So I rummaged through the cabinets and found it. After a few seconds of wiping my butt with it, I felt a burning sensation. Looked at the wet wipe package and realized I was wiping my butt with floor cleaner floor wipes. I'm not a beautician, but sometimes while getting my own waxes, my beautician would tell me stories. I'm calling my beautician Claire to make the story simple. Claire had a regular client who needed a wax while Claire was out of town. I guess she got someone not very experienced. She poured too much wax on in the wrong place, held one side down, tore the wax off and tore this poor woman's clitoris. Not somewhere you want stitches, so the hospital gave her some glue. They even had fun blue glitter glue. The client was a stripper and said at the very least she had something to talk about with her own clientele, and I think she managed to score some sympathy horror tips out of it. But holy crap. OMG, that's so awful, WTF. So, this story spread like wildfire for obvious reasons in our neighborhood. A friend of mine recently opened a beauty salon. She offered to model for one of the new hires to train her on a Brazilian. The problem is, if you're the one laying there being the model, you can't actually properly train the girl at the same time. Larger, more established salons typically have several trainers and models. Girl training puts the hard wax. Hard wax is used closer to the inner lips. Honest lady that owns the lady in the lady says, "Hum, that feels like a lot of wax." And the girl in training tries to reduce the amount before it dries. As verbally directed, the trainee then proceeds to rip the wax off as one does and says, "Oh, are you on your period? There's a lot of blood." The lady is numb with pain, says, "Oh no honey, I haven't had my period in years," since she is postmenopausal. "It's fine, let's just finish up," realizes something is seriously wrong and frantically cleans up, tosses her panties and pants on and rushes home. Lady gets home and asks her daughter to look at her lady bits for her because she's too scared at this point too. Her daughter takes one glance and is like, "Nope, we need to go to the ER right now." They get to the hospital and this trainee, no joke, has ripped off a piece of this poor woman's labia and she is permanently disfigured. The lady can't even sue or anything because it was her own beauty salon that she was responsible for. I still can't pick my jaw up from the floor from this story, and it's been 6 months since I first heard it. When I was in cosmetology school, we had to practice Brazilians on one another. My usual class partner, who was chef's kiss at waxing, wasn't there for the day it was my turn to be waxed. And I was partnered with another girl. I liked her as a person, but OMG, she had no idea what she was doing. She wasn't pulling my skin at all, so I was trying to grapple down there and make everything taut. She was waxing in improper directions and pulling the strip the wrong way, then having to rewax and doing it again. A classmate stood over my face at one point and asks, "How's it going?" and I snapped, "Do not approach me," while my coochie meow meow is being massacred. The prof ended up having to take over. By the end of it, I had burns, some tears, and my entire no-no square was red for a week. 0/10, do not recommend. New client comes in for a Brazilian wax. She's nice but super quiet. I always try to make conversation with my clients to keep their mind off of the pain, but she is not talking. Get about 3 strips in and she starts seizing. I'm obviously scared to death and I'm trying to get her to roll onto her side or sit up. After she stops seizing, she sits up, says she's fine and smiles. I ask her if she wants to continue and she says yes. I go about the rest of the wax the entire time thinking WTF was that. Later was talking to my husband about it. I was a little traumatized and was asking him if there's anything I should have done differently. And he goes, "That wasn't a seizure, it was probably an orgasm." Made total sense after he said it. I've also had women fart in my face, have poop on their buttholes, smell terrible, etc. I could go on and on. I tip my esthetician well so she doesn't tell her stories on Reddit. If you're curious about waxing but not ready to go for a Brazilian, I recommend having your underarms done. It's fantastic and so convenient if you can tolerate the grow out. Not mine, but my friend had a Brazilian wax for an elderly lady. The lady undressed and laid down on her elbows with her butt up. As my friend was going to apply the wax, the lady began slowly pooping liquid and didn't notice until she was kindly asked if she would like to freshen up in the bathroom. The lady went and washed off like nothing happened and still expected my friend to finish a wax. She finished, but she came home really shaken up about it. Not me, but my girlfriend was an esthetician for a while. She attended a pretty big and well-known school. One day when the class was doing Brazilians on models, friends and families and sometimes complete strangers who would come in for free student waxes, one of the students got a clump of wax stuck on the model's labia. The instructor came over and ripped it off, and with it the whole piece of skin. The instructor was fired and the model sued the school. After graduation, my girlfriend got a job at a place adjacent to a hot yoga studio. Women would come in immediately post hot yoga and pre-shower. She's not in that industry anymore. My first time doing Brazilian wax on a client, I put too much wax and couldn't remove it. Then I put a lot of baby powder and it still wouldn't come off. Then I thought it would be great to put more wax and try to remove it again. Didn't work. She was pee and somehow removed that powder wax mess herself. Traumatizing experience for both of us, and I never tried to do Brazilian wax on someone ever again. This happened to me. I was the client though. Several years ago, I had a piercing on my clitoral hood. Whenever I got a Hollywood wax, I'd always feel apprehensive about the wax getting stuck to the jewel. Having recently moved to a new area, I visited the local beauty parlor where I voiced my concerns. "Don't worry," said the lady, "I will tweeze the area near your clitoris rather than wax it." She ended up pinching my clit with the tweezers. Hard. This was 10 years ago. I don't even have that piercing anymore. And I haven't trusted anybody to wax my lady parts since. I'm a licensed esthetician. I do my own Brazilian waxes. Image laying the wax improperly and wondering how you're A. gonna get it off. B. How much extra is this gonna hurt? You learn pretty quickly what to do and not do when you're doing it on yourself. Those first few times are rough. I get waxed and the lady doing it told me that they no longer wax men, because once a guy came in and sexually abused one of the staff while she was waxing him. It's so sad. My mom has worked in health and beauty before. Whilst she didn't wax private areas, she said the worst thing she has seen was someone came for a haircut and there were maggots in her hair. Mum also did professional massage and she was fortunate not to have any creeps, but she said she always knew if someone had eaten curry. Massages are really relaxing. Training to do triple X waxing, and one of my first customers was an extremely thankful deaf woman. An extremely thankful deaf woman trying to cover. She was so thankful because she spent the last 2 weeks living in a caravan with no shower whilst also being on her period. It would make it so much easier to stay clean down there. And no, she didn't use tampons. If aroma could peel paint, her vaginal odor would have been a sandblaster. Needless to say, I made a new rule and stuck to eyebrows. Not an aesthetician, just the victim of one a decade ago. Went to my regular place, but something went wrong and returned home with an extreme burning sensation. I called a couple hours later and they gave me some cream for the area. Took a car trip that weekend. After 3 hours of riding commando in blue jeans, I had to make an emergency stop for baby powder. It was a painful weekend, to say the least. All these years later, I have a natural reverse landing strip now. BC, they damaged the skin and caused scar tissue to grow. No hair grows right up the middle. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.